First of all, thank you for interviewing me. I appreciate it. I appreciate it very much. The book is here, right here. It's called Itamar Kai. It's a book that was first published in Hebrew, of course, in Israel. I write in Hebrew back in the 1990s, and describes it's a sort of a satire on the political and social and cultural environment in Israel as it was more than 25 years ago. And the translator who read it thought that this was very appropriate for Germany, because actually it describes what's going on in Germany in 2024. So I was very happy to have him translate it. I heard it was a good translation. The book is about, I would say, cancel culture, as they call it now. The term did not exist back in the 1990s. It's about cancel culture. It's about not allowing people to express, in a democratic society, not allowing people to express their political views, crushing artists because of certain politically incorrect political views. And this is what happens to my hero, Itamar Kay, when he wants to make a movie and there's something there that's not politically correct. Basically, then he does not make the movie, and he has no future as an artist in Israel. And that is the sad situation that exists there, existed there, still exists there, and I think exists now all over the West, both in America and in Europe.
Thank you. And there was a cancellation yesterday with the Deutsch-Israelische Gesellschaft Berlin. What do you feel about that?
Well, it shows that the book is prophetic, okay? That there's a Talmudic saying that the prophecy ended in the Jewish people with the destruction of the temple. No, of course, this is a joke. I was not surprised. That's the honest truth. I mean, this is the German-Israeli society, friendship society. And I think for many reasons, I think perhaps because of the name Netanyahu nowadays, because of the war, my political views are well known in Israel. I'm used to this kind of canceling also in Israel. I was not surprised that they did it. What was interesting is that they gave some sort of a lame excuse, because of the different organizations and where I appeared here in Hanover, supposedly ultra-right organizations, which of course is nonsense, and that's why they cannot take part of it. So they wrote, they sent me the letter that they wrote to the people who wanted to attend the event, and then wrote me, "I hope you understand." And I told them, of course I understand. There's no question I understand, because my book deals exactly with
yes.
The use of the contemptible cancellation and silencing of art and artists because of their political views or because of political considerations. So of course I understand. And what happened right now in Berlin is exactly something that came out of the pages of this book.
What is your message to the German Christian society? What should they do, especially the Christian people?
I'm not sure the message should be different for the Christian people, those who are believers and those who are non-believers. Those who want the survival of the West, and Israel is, I would say, an example of what the West should be doing. If you want to survive, you have to deal with this huge problem of Muslim extremism, of radical Islam that wants to destroy you. That is what they want.
Yeah.
And for them, they hate Israel. Yeah, they hate the Jews, but they, in a large measure, hate Israel because they hate the West, because they consider Israel a representative of the West. The target is the West, the destruction of the West. And this is what Christians should realize. This is what all good people should realize in Europe. And so they should, of course, support Israel all the way to the end, to the very end, because this is their lives, not only the lives of... We will win. And I think I'm more optimistic about the fate of Israel than I am about the fate of Europe.
Thank you very much, Mr. Netanyahu. Have a good trip. And you next are in Bamberg.
Yes, it is. I'll be going there today. First time I'll be seeing the city. They say it's a very beautiful city, and I hope to see some of it. And I thank you very much for conducting this interview and also for hosting me with the Christian Society for my book. Thank you very much.